I'm stuck here. This is what happened at the end of the second period. Jari's trying to give that to a fan. Marchand takes it off his stick. And they have words. And then Marchand's just going to throw the puck away.
And he took a Billy Swift, Smith swipe at somebody. Smith, a couple of bids. Marchand bangs away. And Jari makes yet another series of saves. And Marchand is hot.
Showed you that exchange even in between periods between Jari and Marchand. Marchand's going to get an opportunity right here. Jari makes a good stop, able to squeeze it with the left arm. Taylor Hall had an opportunity in there. Marchand comes in with a right punch to the side of the head of Jari. That got reaction from all the Penguins as well as it should. And then Marchand went as, you know, when he was trying to continue to go after Jari. He reaches up with his stick here, you know, the mask of the Pittsburgh goaltender.
I was looking at the monitor down here between the benches, and wow, that was at Kadri right there. And that was, I mean, if he wants to swing, he can, but he gave him a swing and a miss right there.
And then he shot the puck toward Kemper.
Yeah, that's the part that I missed that part.
Right. So he's trying to fire up his team.
And here we go with 91 comes over there afterwards. And Binnington's not going to back away from that.
Heck, he tried to fight Kyle Clifford last, or a couple of years ago. He'll take on anyone.
Well, then last year he...
For your entertainment pleasure on a late Saturday afternoon where the Red Wings are down by three, here's Mickey's rant on why Vinny Prospo gets a 10-minute misconduct.
This is awful. Are we living in a sensitive world or what?
He points at the scoreboard.
Tell me what is wrong with that. It's unsportsmanlike?
It's big time unsportsmanlike.
Far too sensitive we are. That's awful. Holy jumping.
Sharp angle, quick shot, save Elvis, and there's the horn. Greenway and Elvis face to face.
Elvis gave the back of his leg a little tug. Greenway, and he stuttered for a second, caught his footing, and then he turned around and just went nose to nose with Elvis Merzlikins. Elvis has had enough of guys standing in front of him, especially big guys like Greenway, Foligno, Bjugstad. All guys over 6 foot four, Bjugstad 6 foot six, and they're all camped right in on the edge of the paint of Elvis Merzlikins. Doesn't mind that. It's 18 white, Greenway. That puck gets pulled away, and then Elvis pulls Greenway in. And then Gavrikov, Werenski sort out the bodies in front. They had a 6-on-6 scrum last night where the goalies got into it.
Well, we have some entertainment down here, that is for sure. We've got Brad Marchand and Artemi Panarin yelling at each other. And right during the play, Artemi Panarin actually took his glove off and threw it across right over me to Brad Marchand. We'll see if we can get a look at it. Here he, right behind the linesman. And it was, I don't mean to laugh because it is heated, very intense, but it was... Here I am. Yes, I did feel like, you know, I mean, my kids are in the building. It's Thanksgiving. There's a lot of that going on in our house as well, too, throwing things at each other. So.
Oh, the rivalry's back, Sam. Uh-oh.
The rivalry
is heating up now.
Can you believe the Rangers are up 3-1? They were down 1-0. The Islanders were doing everything right. Then all of a sudden, Boyle.
And,
yep.
And you can bet that Boyle would love to get back at Abdelkader for the fight on Blunden at the end of the game. Guys are falling down at the other end. Boyle's talking big time to Abdelkader. And they're going to go. Boyle's got the right hand loose, and he's big. 6-6. Now, Abdelkader's still got his right glove on.
Fans are throwing.
And the referee gets
beverages
in the middle.
On the ice. Oh, Boyle got a right hand loose. And that's where Eric Berlatt, the referee, can't tie up one arm here. That's
well,
what Abdelkader
what he's
got to
do is warn Boyle that if he goes on, when Abdelkader doesn't want to go right now, that he can suspend him. And he's got possibly a bad hand from that fight the other night.
With London, for sure.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, look at Boyle. Look at Boyle. Look at Boyle.
Oh, a little chicken wing here tonight. Well, he's got the bad hand. He's telling the referee, I don't want to fight.
Yeah, he showed him the tape on his hand. Boyle didn't like it. Look at.
Well, if game two.
It's NHL hockey.
Set up a determined game three.
And Achari will pin it to the wall. We'll go to the third. LIIGA the hit on Coleman there. Coleman didn't like it. And Vetrano and Colton going at it. Now Achari with a face full of Blake Coleman.
And there's going to be some calls made here right at the end of this second period.
Oh, now out at center ice. I'm not sure what Vetrano did, but both Killorn and Stamkos grab Frank Vetrano.
Well, he had the helmet of Colton, I think.
Panthers still arguing the call. Barkov is still on the ice. Oh, and look at Patrick Maroon again taunting the Panthers. Lomberg is still on the ice watching this, talking back to him. Remember Lomberg and Maroon, I mentioned they were
trying to get it back in a sail. Here's a good look at it. He just catches the, ouch, the curve on that glass, and oh yeah, right in the face. And thankfully, you know, the league changed that. You go back one more time and show you what happens to Mackenzie Entwistle after he gets hit. So he'll hit his face, which we showed, but as he's skating back to the bench, look at the bench, watch what what Ben does to him, squirts him in the face with some water, a little insult to injury. You see he looks back and you wonder if the league might take a look at that. A little unsportsmanlike, potentially a fine. Hopefully they're watching. Ben, a guy who's not afraid to mix it up. He will drop his gloves. He's been the captain of this team for quite a while.
And before that, we had this little exchange here. Clayton Keller, who's been a thorn on the Bruins side all night with his ability to handle the puck and make plays. This went on for quite a while between the two of them as play continued. Yet he still wanted to defend, and Marchand wanted to tie him up and not let him get to where he wanted to go to get some new lumber. And it allowed Charlie McAvoy on the other side of the ice to step into the offensive zone. He just couldn't drag the puck with him enough when he made a move to the slot.
Panarin down low for Buchnevich. He was tied up. Oh, Van Riemsdyk with a terrific play on Buchnevich. Now they're pounding Buchnevich on the ice.
Now Wilson.
Wilson's throwing punches.
Yeah, well, he went after, I think, Buchnevich.
Oh, boy.
Now Wilson.
This is ridiculous.
Panarin.
What is Wilson doing?
Well, you know, he has been incensed ever since he was given that penalty.
So he goes after Panarin?
Well, no, he went, well, that was after the rest of it. But while Buchnevich was trying to get, jam the puck in, Wilson on Buchnevich.
Now he's having a yelling session at the Rangers bench. And this is where Wilson loses it.
Well, let's see what happens. So he got Wilson 43. He punched Buchnevich, and Strome saw it and did the right thing and jumped on top of him. And then Wilson, and then Panarin saw it. So Panarin jumps on Wilson, and then Wilson wrestles him down. And then this is why Buchnevich and Dillon, who's a physical player. But here's what's happened with Buchnevich goes down. And Wilson is on him, and he forces him straight down his head, and then punches him. And that's when Strome sees it. Good for Strome.
Now, what does that merit?
You know, it merits something if they saw it. And so then Wilson takes a shot, and then you see how strong Wilson is as Panarin's on his back, and Wilson will pick him up and body slam. Here it is again. 89-43 is Wilson, and right there it punches him, and then Strome sees that and comes to his help.
That's where Wilson makes a mockery of the game. There was no call for what he did. Okay. That's impressive.
I don't know who he's.